Yep, another South Park review. Welcome back. Reason why I'm doing this again, because I have another day off on a Wednesday. And I'm like, it's 8 o'clock, South Park's on, it's time to do another review again. Time to do another South Park episode. So this is about, finally, it's about the four boys. Cartman, Kenny, Stan, Kyle, about them again. I mean, those other episodes was really about them. It was about everybody. Now I went back to just those four boys in this newer episode. And the thing is, like, the whole episode is not all about airsofts, which you saw in the trailer of the next episode. No. The whole episode is not about airsofts, playing airsofts with teenagers, stuff like that. It's something totally different. Well, it's not totally different. It's just that they end up, doing stuff with these teenagers, but the thing is, they're like hormonal as fuck and they act like assholes, which most teenagers do in real life. So this is mostly about Cartman, Kenny, Kyle's, and Stan taking care of their teenagers. That's right, they're supposed to be like their parent or something. Like, I don't get that. And they show how teenagers are in real life, how retarded they are, how stupid they act, they do stupid fucking shit, a bunch of acne on their faces and shit, all hormonal, keep telling the boys that I'll kill you, stuff like that, keep threatening to kill them, shit like that, because that's how they are. I can understand, teenagers are a pain in the ass, like, raising them and shit, they're like a real, like, a nightmare, deal with those fucking brats. I can understand what Trey Parker and Matt Stone are trying to tell here. Maybe because they're telling this because their kids are teenagers now and they're a pain in the ass. I don't know. I don't know if their kids are actually in their teens. They could be. And they're probably annoying the shit out of them, so they made an episode about them. I don't know. I don't fucking know. I don't know their fucking kids or them. Because what happened here is, like, Kyle takes his dad, Gerald, to this airsoft store to buy some guns. His dad doesn't know it's okay for him to do that. Because, he knows it's dangerous and stuff like that. But he still gets it for him, and, the boys go to the airsoft place with the name being Floppy Dick Team. That's their name of their team. But they end up getting their own teenager to work with to play in the airsoft game. And they have real fun. They're enjoying it and stuff like that. They're all happy leaving the place, stuff like that. Cartman's actually, tearing up about it. He had, the best time of his life. He went back to his hot dog house. Yeah, they're continuing that. I don't know why this show likes to do continuations now. I don't understand that. I remember the show used to be like an on and off thing. No, not on and off thing. It used to be like a one time thing. Every time they do episodes, like a one time thing, and it goes back to normal. And now it's like a continuation now. Cartman still lives in the Coney Island hot dog, I guess, from that episode, the third episode, like one of the worst episodes of the series. One of the worst episodes of 25th season, I meant. The whole beginning and middle of this episode, it's alright. But at the end, it gets way better. I'm gonna tell you right now. So what happened here is, Kyle, Stan, Cartman, and Kenny had enough with the teenagers getting them fucking trouble and shit and being assholes. They had enough of it. So that they started talking shit to them at the airsoft place, tell them they want to be bothered no more, they want on their team anymore because they're so annoying and always hormonal and shit. They act like ass wipes. I keep saying bruh all the time. I hate that word, bruh, bruh, bruh. That's just like a fucking the most laziest slang ever. It's just like annoying as fuck the way they say that shit. Use the word bruh. I find you use the word bro. I think that word is cooler. Just say bro or some shit. Even though I never use those words at all in my life, I use the word just man. That's mostly the slang I use is man or dude. I don't like use those other words. That's not my fucking style. Because I'm not a fucking a dork. So, the kids are tired of them being ass wipes. So now, their parents, Stan's dad, Randy, Gerald, Kyle's dad, and Candy's dad. They end up going to airsoft place to buy some airsoft guns to get back at those teenagers, and they all came there to help them out. Kyle shows up also with the other three dads, and Cartman's sad. He don't have a dad, and he's still living in a hot dog place. And Randy tells fucking Cartman that he got Uncle Jimbo on his side to help him out. And Uncle Jimbo has like this big ass fucking machine gun on him, this big ass minigun. He had this fucking big ass fucking goggle eye thing and shit. I was like, damn, this about to get crazy. Because you know Jimbo has a whole bunch of real guns in his place, and you know that guy loves the guns to death. You know, that's his dad right there, is Uncle Jimbo. You know, because you know Cartman doesn't have a dad anymore because what happened? The whole, you know, Scott Tenman Must Die episode. Which I don't want to spoil anything if anyone hasn't watched the episode, even though a lot of people did. But anyways, yeah. So now the whole shit happens, you know, the kids and the dads team up with each other to take out those teenagers, which they did. Cartman goes in the kid's bathroom and shoot him up while his pants is down, and he hit him the balls too. He's like, oh, my dick! But that shit was funny. And they took all the kids out. Fucking, Randy put his fucking Integrity Farms vaccination special Wee stuff out in the open to get the kids over there, the teenagers over there. Get them smelling it, get them distracted, so they throw a bomb and take them all out. And they all walk away all happy and stuff like that. The fathers and the kids. The kids walk away, go into hot dog place, make some hot dogs for everyone, and fucking Randy about to take the kids out, and he was like Kyle's dad stops him. He's like, don't do it yet. They're not teenagers yet. Which is gonna happen. They're gonna go to the same shit also when they grow up to be teenagers. They're gonna annoy the fuck out of them when they get older, turn to teenagers. Like I said, fuck. Man, when I have kids in the future, and once a kid turns a teenager, this would be a fucking nightmare. Teenagers would be a pain in the ass to raise. That's what I feel like was gonna happen. Because, you know, the hormones just rage inside their testicles and shit, you know? It gets all fucking roared and shit. It's like they're some fucking steroids or something. You know, they're not. But it's really just, you know, fucking hormone rage. Because they need to fuck something, you know? Get all their hormones out of them. Bad attitudes and whatnot, you know? Especially the teenage girls with their periods and shit, you know? Oh, my God, like... It's gonna be a nightmare for all of us when we have kids, when they're teenagers and shit. It's gonna be tough, you know. Cause like, yeah, teenagers are nightmares. You gotta fucking keep grounding their asses. They're gonna do something stupid, you know. Ground them for like a month or something if you did some fucking retarded shit, you know. It's gonna be like a pain in the ass. This is what Trey Parker and Matt Stone is telling how annoying teenagers are. It basically explains the whole episode how annoying they are. But what do I think about this episode? I would say it's better than episode fucking 1 and 3. I'll say it right now. It's better than those fucking episodes. To be fair. Even though this episode wasn't really that funny. I mean, I still laugh. You know, I got chuckles out of me. The most funny part was the ending. Where the dads show up and help them out and stuff like that. Especially Uncle Jimbo with his big ass fucking minigun. Even though they should have some more, you know, like really fucked up shit happen this episode, but which they didn't. It's mostly just, you know, annoying teenagers being annoying teenagers with their attitudes and shit. It's basically what the whole episode's about, and that mostly just pissed me off because, you know, I can't stand teenagers in general. And their fucking acnes and shit. I mean, I had a lot of acne when I was a teenager and stuff like that, but I wasn't like a real pain in the ass as a teenager. I wasn't a total dickhead to my parents or anything like that. No. You know, I wasn't like that when I was a teenager. I wasn't a big douche. My older brother was, though. Me? Nah, I wasn't like that when I was a teenager. I was pretty laid back. You know. I wasn't like that. Yeah, I got angry a few times and stuff like that at times. But not like every fucking day I was angry. You know, I was on road, fucking roid rage like most of these teenagers are these days. But this episode's not bad. I would say is a decent episode. Just like episode 2, I thought that was decent like that one. Well, it seems like in total of season 25, I only like 2 out of 5 episodes in general. The other 3, not really that great. Especially the episode where fucking Cartman gets his mom fired from her job. You know, she wanted to pay money for the house. But they ended up moving to Coney Island Hot Dog instead because Cartman's a fat idiot. I really miss the vulgar humor, the raunchiness that Sauber used to had. I really miss that shit. I miss when fucking Cartman used to call Kyle a Jew. I miss when Kyle used to call Cartman a fat ass. I miss that shit. I miss when he used to call each other names and shit. But they don't do that no more. Because they're not afraid. It's just that, I don't know what it is, but it's stupid. They should just do that again. Like they used to do. I don't know why they stopped that in the first place. And I'm like, besides that, the Airsoft episode. I feel like for like the final battle of the Airsoft War, it should be like real bullets and shit. Like you get like real guns, they start blasting each other, like blood and shit like that. Arms get blown off. You know, like that should have been way funnier, but they didn't do that because I don't know why. I don't know what it is. Like I said, I think it's because people get offended or something. I don't know what it is. I don't think Super Crazy even care to get offended. But I think that would have been better for the episode if the final Airsoft War it should have been like real bullets. That should have been way funnier, I think. But then again, they didn't go with the idea for some reason. But yeah, this episode is pretty decent. This is definitely better episodes 1, 3, and 4, I'll tell you that. Especially the fucking 3rd and 4th episode. Jesus Christ, like, those episodes were really bad. Especially the 4th episode, where about the whole fucking Russia-Putin thing. That shit was like a really bad episode. Nothing really happens to that episode at all. Especially like that fucking 3rd episode where Cartman fucks over his mom. And episode 1 of Pajama Day, that shit's stupid as fuck. It's not really a good season. But like I said, people are saying that Trey Parker and Matt Stone doing it on purpose because they want the show to get to end already. Which I gotta understand, they're bored of this shit now, I think. Like, this should've been going for, like, too long now. It's like decades and decades now. This should've been going for too long. It's not. Like I said before, this is Comedy Central's fucking power source. Like, once they cut the core out of this show, they're fucked. Because they had nothing else on there. Oh, they got Fairview on there. Who the fuck watches that shit? That shit's fucking garbage. They have nothing. It's nothing. The only new thing that's coming back is Beavis and Butthead. Supposed to be on Comedy Central, but the show didn't come back yet. Mike Judge still working on it. It's supposed to air on Comedy Central, but I don't want to just show the repeats. I don't get what the big deal is. Because the whole music videos are really copyrighted or something. I don't know what it is. I don't get what the big deal is. Just music. Shouldn't be that fucking badly copyrighted. But yeah, this episode is pretty decent. I don't know. I don't know if I want to continue doing these episode reviews. I'm really getting really bored doing these reviews because it's the same old thing. Like, mostly all these episodes are basically watered down. This isn't that same humor that I used to have a long time ago with the show. This isn't that same humor. That's not that same raunchiness and weird shit anymore. It's not that real fucked up humor anymore like it used to have. That doesn't have that anymore. It's just a watered down version now of the show. It's like very clean. But yeah, like I said, this is pretty decent.